Well, good Monday morning to everyone. I hope that you enjoyed a great weekend. I know I did. I know that we did at the Journey, and really excited to start off a brand new week. This morning, I'm going to take you to the book of Nahum in the Old Testament. It is basically the letter that's written next about Nineveh. So if you were listening on Saturday morning, you heard me boil down Jonah to just a few verses at the end of chapter number 4, that the whole book was put together to give us a specific message about God's desire to forgive and to save. Unfortunately for Nineveh, it didn't take. They had a revival, and then they went right back to being the same as they were before. It's kind of like 9/11. We had revival where everybody turned to the Lord and then immediately went back and picked up where they left off, even being more so into their sin. And the church suffered really just kind of a cooling off period almost. And so that's what's happening in the book of Nineveh. In the book of Nahum, Nineveh, about 80 to 100 years after Jonah, is so bad that destruction is coming. Now, there's a lot of Old Testament things that happened that may give us some understanding better of why that city was targeted. But let's just look at it from the perspective of what we can learn from it this morning. I'm just going to read 7 verses and let you just hear what Nahum is all about. Verse number 1 starts off this way. It says, the burden of Nineveh, the book of the vision of Nahum the Elkoshite. God is jealous and the Lord revengeth. The Lord revengeth and is furious. The Lord will take vengeance on his adversaries, and he reserveth wrath for his enemies. Obviously, Nineveh is in the Assyrian Empire and a part of the destruction of God's people, attacks on God's people. So Nineveh, being a capital city, is an easy selection for this. The Lord is slow to anger and great in power, and will not at all acquit the wicked. The Lord hath his way in the whirlwind and in the storm, and in the clouds are the dust of his feet. And so he says it's easy for the Lord to do this, but he's slow about it because even his enemies get an opportunity to repent. The next verse says, he rebuketh the sea and maketh it dry. He drieth up all the rivers. Bashan languisheth, Carmel and the flower of Lebanon languisheth. The mountains quake at him and the hills melt. The earth is burned at his presence. Yea, the world and all that dwelleth therein. Who can stand before his indignation, and who can abide in the fierceness of his anger? His fury is poured out like fire, and the rocks are thrown down by him. The Lord, listen to this though, the Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knoweth them that trust him. And so even in the midst of it all, God knows how to isolate out the true followers of him and have his vengeance fall specifically on enemies or those that reject him. Verse number 8 kind of clears this up. It says, but with an overrunning flood, he will make an utter end of the place thereof, and the darkness shall pursue his enemies. And so God gives opportunity for repentance. But if repentance does not take, if repentance does not stay, then God will exert judgment on those that push him away. And so we see that Jonah wasn't necessarily as wrong as we thought. He was wrong in assuming that once people are messed up, that there is no second chance. God is a God of second chances. He does give those chances. But once those chances are turned away from, once we've exhausted all of the chances that God is planning to give, then he goes right back to the plan that he has for his enemies. And so this morning I realized that's not like a happy message. But it is a truth. You don't, as a believer in Lord Jesus Christ, you don't have to be the one that makes everyone pay. You can live your life and know this confidently, that God knows his own and he takes care of them. His vengeance falls actually only on the people that reject him. And so as a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ, you can walk confidently in any storm, knowing that if you're walking with the Lord, it won't be his vengeance that lands on you. And so I hope that that helps you as you face the week. I don't know what's coming your way, but just know this, that God's vengeance and wrath is reserved for those that reject him, and it does not fall on those who are walking with him. I hope that helps you. Have a great day.